Monica Martínez, running for Suffolk County Legislature. I am the incumbent. I've been in office for 22 months. It's been a great 22 months that we've been in office with my staff, who has been great since we've been in office. Many things have happened in the district that has never happened before here in the district. For example, record funding, not only to local community-based organizations, but funding to the school district, which had never happened in this district before. Also, aside from the funding, we also opened a resource center where we have the Department of Labor, Department of Social Services, and the Department of Human Rights Commission come in and service our residents during the week at a center that we opened on Suffolk Avenue, but we're now in the midst of moving it to Central Islip, so Central Islip can also have this resource center. Within that resource center, we've also created a community-based initiative where we have invited all the community leaders to come in and to really look at what the district is in need of, look at what we have, and take what we have to make our district better. Aside from that, we have also secured a grant for Central Islip to see if we can connect with Southwest Seward District. Unfortunately, I'm sure some of you have heard in the newspaper, the Lekankama Hub, it was supposed to go through Islandia, through Central Islip. The county executive and Mayor Dorman didn't really agree on certain things, so they took a different road and they went south, and we ended up getting the short end of the stick, and we were able to secure $200,000 for a feasibility study to see if Central Islip can hook up to the Southwest Sewer District, which that will start next year. And right now I'm also looking into the feasibility for Brentwood to connect to sewer districts on Fifth Avenue. Aside from that, we have also, due to the closing of Roberto Clemente Park, we were able to give our children free summer camp for 2 years in a row. We serviced about 600 kids throughout 2014 and 2015 due to the park being closed. Aside from the park issue that we had, we also had a sheet metal facility trying to be built here in Brownwood. We've been trying to make sure that doesn't happen. We have also fought, like I said, with the park. We have 30 seconds. We have moved our office closer to the people. All right, before me coming in, the office was outside. People's ability to get there. We are now in the heart of Brentwood on 2nd Avenue, where people can come in whenever they want. Our clientele has increased and walk-ins have increased tremendously. So also the health center they wanted to move into a different area as well, causing our residents more havoc in traveling there. We were able to secure the health center to remain where it's located, as well as transferring it over to a federally qualified health center. Thank you.
I'm Giovanni Marta, and I'm running for Suffolk County Legislator in the 9th Legislative District, Brentwood, North Bayshore, and Central Islip. And as a business-to-government specialist since 2006, it is my goal to make sure that all the businesses in our district, particularly in Brentwood, have the resources and the tools that they need in order for them to be successful. Because if our businesses locally are successful, we have a successful community. So part of my strategy to make sure when we become a legislator, when I'm elected, is to make sure that we have all the initiatives to work in conjunction with the chamber and have all of those resources available, made available to the chamber. I think I have an issue with this here. Sorry. And make sure that all resources available from the county government and working with other government entities to make sure that we empower and that we revitalize our businesses locally, especially in Brentwood, speaking of the Brentwood Chamber, because that's the only way that our communities will be having all of the needs met in order for them to become the employment opportunity for our community members and making sure that we have all the resources. I do want to make sure that we also advocate for an expansion of the sewer system in Brentwood. I believe that we have a lot of restaurants, a lot of this type of businesses in Brentwood that contribute tremendously to our community, but the sewer system is always causing a lot of issues for this community, for these businesses. So I want to make sure that we look for all the venues, for all the alternatives that we have in order for us to make sure that we have the right, that we are on the right track in order for the business to be and meet, you know, the growing expectation that we have in our community. I also feel that we have not enough resources for community development in Brentwood. Particularly, they asked me to say about Brentwood, so, but I will speak about the district. But in Brentwood, we need to make sure that we have additional resources for community development resources, that way that we can implement initiatives that will continue to enhance, that we can promote the business attractions and the consumers to come to Brentwood. Pathmark is closing, as you know, in a couple of weeks. We cannot let this happen in the future. We need to make sure that the local businesses struggling have the resources from government or from any other means in order for them to stay here, stay locally, and that we can actually advocate for them and we assist them. Time is up. Any questions? Thank you. So now I will open any questions. If anybody has any questions, concerns.
You say tools and resources. Businesses. What tools and resources?
Okay, well, okay. His question was, what tools and what resources? The Long Island Development Corporation has resources available and tools in regards in pertaining to empowering your business. Let's say you want to improve your business, but you don't have the capital, and you need funding, and you need training, and you need all these type of, training or professional development for your business staff or even for the owners. These corporations, or this, including the Small Business Administration, the Long Island Development Corporation, and other community development agencies have loans available, have trainings available, and all other means that will assist your business in order for you to become a successful business in whatever industry you are. So those are the tools and resources that I'm speaking about.
Thank